Hello and welcome to the LISE campus. I'm Matthias Schöbel and I'm software and automation specialist here since nearly 20 years. And me and my colleague would like to introduce you today to our speech on efficiency increase and cost savings due to automatic furnace bed loading.
Hello, my name is Bernhard Leitner. I'm product manager for logistics. Today we have the pleasure to present you our new furnace bed loading solution and unloading solution. We offer since 20 years automatic furnace bed loading and unloading solutions. So we had done some several integration of third-party furnaces in the last years. We start with freefall tables, further to belt roller conveyors, and now we can offer additionally to the conveyor our new robots. The know-how behind the machines is in our software, GPS AutoFab. The big advantage between former machines is the less needed space, so the robots find also place in smaller holes. This makes the robot very interesting for retrofitting. Another benefit is the flexibility of the robot. We can modify it easily for special customer wishes or products. The robot system can be installed in front and after the furnace. A laser marking system in front of the robot can be added optionally. The scanner after the furnace is a requirement for the automatic unloading of the furnace. Later, more to that. To the workflow. Sheets coming from the automatic sorting system to a horizontal belt conveyor. The conveyor moves the glass to the laser marking position. There, a laser makes a logo on it. After the laser process, the belt conveyor moves the glass to a picking position for the robot. The loading robot takes the glass and places it on the inlet of the furnace. This position was calculated by our GPS AutoFab. After toughening, the glass is scanned. Due to scanning result, the robot gets the information if a glass is broken or turned. That allows us to react to non-planned situations. For example, we turn our suction cups device parallel to the sheet. So when the sheet is a little bit turned, in the furnace, it's no problem. The robot brings single sheets to the reloading position. And on a belt conveyor, the glass moves to a sorting system again. Our functions. Thanks to a 7-axis on the robot can reach each position on the inlet and outlet. Also, jumbo size are possible. Small sheets with less than 125 kilograms we can handle easily by pick and place. Furthermore, we can turn these sheets with the rotating head of the robot to any inclination. No extra machine is needed for the turning. To handle sheets up to jumbo size, we have a drag and drop mode. We push the sheet over the air cushion and roller of the inlet in position. We need only a small robot, keep the design slim, and can handle jumbo sizes. Our software GPS AutoFab calculate which suction cups are needed. We lower only the needed suction cups on the device. The suction cups are never touching the felt or the sheets or other sheets. Also, when the pattern is very close, it's no problem. Another advantage, the suction cups stays longer clean because we never touching the felt. Sheets with small and big cutouts are no issue with this function, because we also calculate that with our GPS AutoFab. If the suction cups to get full of dust or socks are needed for the suction cups, the robot can simply move to a service position. So the operator can easily reach the suction cup device. So we have always a controlled process. So we suck the glass when all suction cups are on it, and we'll release it when it's completely down on the belt conveyor. The suction cups do not slide over the glass, as it can happen at conventional suction cup devices. So there are no marks on the glass from the sliding suction cups on it.
I would like to guide you through the integration possibilities of this solution. The most important part is the pre-sorting at the buffering stage in front of the furnace. All the glasses which are available in the buffer can be used for the furnace bed optimization, which allows us a very efficient loading of the furnace. Those glasses in the buffer are sorted by furnace recipe because we are not possible to temper 4 mm with 6 mm glass together. Therefore, these recipes are used to separate the glasses in the buffer. Furthermore, some furnaces require a defined size. Furthermore, some furnaces require defined size groups and categories from small to large. And it's not allowed to combine the large with the small ones, but you can combine the small with the medium or the medium with the large ones. This is mainly based on the height of the pieces and how many rows of glasses are loaded to the furnace. A separate category of glasses in the buffer are the remix. Those are taken with priority into account during the optimization and allows to bring them with high speed through the process. Furthermore, for the furnace bed optimization, we have certain pieces to understand. The one thing is that we automatically select the pieces in the buffer. The operator don't need to select the production batch or don't need to select the glass type. This can be done fully automatic, and therefore the operator is only there to control the process, but not interfere with it. Furthermore, when the remix are integrated, the system looks automatically for sizes which are fitting the furnace bed regulations to join them together, so to have also a good utilization when you tempering your remix. The furnaces sometimes require different distances between the pieces. The typical distances are 80 to 100 millimeters, but can also go up to 150 millimeters if the furnace requires it. Some of the pieces are allowed to be rotated based on roller wave requirements. These requirements could be based on the visual impact on the building, so it needs to be tempered in vertical or in horizontal position. The furnace bed optimization also avoids holes within the furnace bed, which means that also cold and hot spots are minimized within the furnace, which could lead to a bad tempering quality of the glasses. Furthermore, a section of the buffer holds test pieces, which are then later used to be broken, and the cullets are counted to see what is the fragmentation level of the glass and the tempering result is acceptable. If the tempering result is not acceptable, those pieces which are produced in the meanwhile can be quarantined and remade. Of course, as my colleague said already, based on this optimization, we also control the suction cups. So we avoid to position suction cups in cutouts or position suction cups outside of a shape, for example. When the furnace bed optimization is done and all the glasses are loaded from the buffer to the furnace, we are handing over also control data to the furnace itself. This control data contains the recipe information, which is important for the furnace to understand which temperature range needs to be adjusted and set for this furnace load. Then, if the glass should be toughened or heat strengthened, which is typically interfering with the cooling time in the quench. And we also hand over the loaded weight and square meters of the glasses, and sometimes also what is the biggest size of a glass within the furnace bed. This is utilized by the modern furnaces to tweak the recipe accordingly to get the perfect tempering result. And furthermore, we also hand over a furnace bed ID, because sometimes a complete furnace bed is broken in the quench And to resynchronize this ID is sent back from the furnace at the unloading stage. At the unloading side, the glasses are automatically delivered horizontally by the furnace through the quality scanning device, and therefore we can check automatically for misalignments. Misalignments means that sometimes pieces are rotating during the movement within the furnace, and therefore we have to adjust our gripper position to proper grip them and deliver them to the unloading side. Also, the furnace can tell us if the quality is okay or not. A typical example for that is the operator is opening the quench because of an error on the furnace, and therefore the whole bed is more or less not tempered and therefore needs to be quarantined and remade. Mainly it goes to the bin, and this is detected automatically. Of course, missing and broken pieces are also detected so that these ones are not automatically unloaded and are not continuing in the further process. The most of the newer integrations have also a distortion measurement system integrated, which allows to measure if the glasses uniformity is correct and within the standards. Based on all this, we can achieve a very low energy consumption on such solutions because, first of all, the furnace is driven in a very efficient way based on the automatic optimization of the furnace beds. Secondly, all glasses available to the furnace are taken into consideration, so we have an optimized continuous process on the furnace. This also leads to a reduced power consumption of the furnace because the furnace don't need to have cooling cycles or heating cycles or even waiting cycles because no glass is available. Therefore, the duty cycle of the furnace is improved and increased. And additionally, the efforts for the operators are also smaller because the operator is mainly controlling the furnace and not working with the furnace, which means he is not loading weights and weights or tons of glass to the furnace and unloads it manually again. So no misalignment of the pieces and the piece ID, no label printing and application manually on the glasses, no human errors, and therefore also the safety of the complete solution is increased because no one is exposed to the glass anymore. Since we are doing this furnace bed loading and unloading solution since 20 years for our customers, we have learned a lot with them. And most of our customers have at the beginning always asked the same questions. And therefore, we would like to give you now the best of the questions from our customers and the corresponding answers to it. Most of the customers have asked why and what is the issue with touching the glass from the top surface with the suction cups.
To find the right suction cup for each surface is always a close cooperation with our customers. So the common way is the customer sends us his suction cups and coated glass for tests. We also, from our experience from other machinery areas, for example, from the laminating area, testing also our suction cups. And so we find the best suction cup for the customer and for his product.
Which type of furnaces can be integrated?
We can integrate single chamber and double chamber batch furnaces and also continuous furnaces.
Most of our customers asked, is this a typical solution for the worldwide application, so also in low wages countries, or is it mainly a solution for the Western market?
Yes, solution for whole over the world. Each country have the problem with the labor, so it is hard to find good and experienced employees. So it's also a product for China, for example.
As we have installed our furnace integration solutions worldwide, how many of those solutions are currently running at our customers?
In the last years, we installed over 100 buffer solutions with 25 furnaces integrations.
As most of our customers, commonly coming from the double glazing business, they have only a few knowledge about tempering furnaces and the integration of such processes. Which parts of the solution can be delivered by LYSEC?
We want to provide always an all-in-one solution. This is the reason why we can offer the machinery, the automation, and also the robot. It's one working package.
We are pleased that we could demystify your view on furnace integration. If you have further questions or would like to talk to us, let's see us in the chat function of our campus. We wish you a very nice virtual show. Thank you.